Well, good Tuesday morning, everyone. Good to see you this morning. Thank you for joining me. We're going to study God's Word together. I am really excited about this. I did choose one of the best books for us to study. I say best in the terms of, what do you mean by best? Because they're all perfect, perfectly written by God. And yes, they are. But Philippians is the book of joy, and I need joy in my life. There's plenty of challenge. There's many encouraging verses. In fact, I was thinking about it the other day, when you ask somebody their favorite verse in the Bible, many, many times those verses come from the book of Philippians, and we're going to come to them, but not today. But in verse 1 of chapter 1, I'll read it to you. It has to be our verse for the day. We're only going to study one verse today, and this is it. But it's packed. It sounds on the surface, maybe not that much, but you'll feel that way, that you gain some real insight as we study it together. So get your Bible. I hope you do. It would really be good if you have your Bible as we study this month of January in this wonderful book. Chapter 1, verse 1. Paul and Timothy, servants of Christ Jesus, to all the saints in Christ Jesus at Philippi, together with the overseers and deacons. Hey, I love the way that they did it in these days. Which was to put right up front who it's from and who it's to. We still put who it's to some. We say, you know, dear Tom or something, dear whoever. So we do that, but we just hold off who it's from to the end, and you sign your letter. Right up front, Paul and Timothy. And there's no question that Timothy was with Paul, but the letter is written by Paul. Timothy might have written some of it down for him or written the whole thing, but it's definitely from Paul, because the word I or me or my is used throughout the book. But I love the description that Paul puts of them. They are what? Did you see it? They are servants of Christ Jesus. Oh, I love that. Is that how you view yourself? Servants of Christ Jesus? It's something to remind ourselves of, and it's something to strive for. More than anything, it's an attitude. Servants of Christ Jesus. You've heard me say before, if you're a regular watcher, I am not a fan of the word volunteer. Would you like to volunteer for such and such? Or we need volunteers. It's not a term that the Bible uses. Well, I mean, can you turn to a book and, I mean, a sentence in the Bible that talks about volunteers? You can't. I know you can't, because the word volunteer is never used one time in the Bible. But it talks over and over and over about servants or slaves, even slaves to Jesus. But servants is the more common. Servants of Christ. Well, if you're a servant, what? You do what the master asks of you. And that is to be our attitude. It's really, I don't have to interpret a lot to that, do I? And yet, so often in the church, when we have volunteers in various positions, they let things get in the way of them fulfilling what they had said they would do. And I just encourage you to adopt this attitude of service. Not that you can't. In fact, we encourage people to travel or or to do, you know, whatever God has laid on their heart. But if you've committed something, then you find the person to fill in for you when you're gone. It's a simple, it's not a hard thing. But I remember scrambling when I was involved with children, especially, and we had Sunday school teachers, how often on a Sunday morning, you know, an hour to church, and and they would call up and say, I just can't make it today. Scratchy throat, can't make it. And boy, the person in charge, that just puts them in such a tough bind. Well, it's the way for any. There's nothing wrong with, I mean, we don't want to encourage anyone to come when they're sick, but to help find that replacement or even have somebody that you just know you could call to fill in would be wonderful. Anyway, as servants of Christ Jesus, maybe we have the same attitude as when we work in a job. We usually show up for that. Anyway, I think God speaks to us on that. But I want to get to the rest of that verse. And he says, to all the saints in Christ Jesus at Philippi. Who's he referring to? All the church members, isn't he? Do you think of yourself as a saint? Well, you should. The Bible repeatedly calls all the church members saints. We don't think of ourselves that way. And you know why? Because we see our sin. We're aware of it. We're familiar with it. We hate it. We've confessed it. We want to not do those things, but we see it. Well, here's the thing. God doesn't see it. He has forgiven our sins and it's washed away, and he sees us as pure, non-sinner saints. Saints. Oh, I find that word very challenging to live up to. And we often fail, don't we? But you remember what Psalm 103 verse 12 says? It says, as far as the east is from the west, that far he has removed our sins from us. It's gone. God has gotten rid of our sins. As far as the east is from the west, that far has he removed our sins from us. And so when I look out and the viewing audience, I just see you as saints. Saint Alan, Saint John, Saint Joey, Saint Debbie, Saint Susie, Saint you. Why? Because that's what God calls you. That's how God sees you. And I don't know how that makes you feel. For me, I'm just in awe. I'm just filled with praise and thanks and God and wonder. God, how can you be like that? How can you love us that much to see us as sinless people? Now, he still asks us to confess it, repent from it, not do it. And that gives us something to shoot for today, doesn't it? To be the saint that God calls us to do. One of the ways we know is just having that, Lord, I'm a servant of you. What do you want me to do today? Am I supposed to, you know, see my neighbor? See, I don't know what it might be, but God, if he's laid something on your heart, a servant does it. Oh, what a great day. What a great start to the book. Hey, tomorrow we're going to dig in. Another great insight for tomorrow. I hope I see you. Bye for now.